Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 30 in Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. We are going to solve problems in the aircraft propulsion. In the earlier two lectures, in the aircraft propulsion, we discussed the turbo propeller engine, turbo jet engine, turbo fan engine, ramjet engine, pulse jet engine, and the scramjet engine. And we discussed the performance of the jet engines and the efficiency of jet engines. And in this lecture, we will be solving problem on aircraft propulsion. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the aircraft propulsion. Example number 1, the diameter of aircraft propeller is 4 meter, the speed ratio is 0.8 at a flight speed of 125 meters per second. If the ambient conditions at the flight altitude are temperature 256 Kelvin and the pressure 0.54 bar, determine propulsive efficiency, thrust and thrust to power. This question appeared in November 2008, May 2009 and November 2013 question paper. So, we write down the given data, diameter of the propeller D equal to 4 meter, speed ratio sigma equal to 0.8, flight speed U equal to 125 meters per second, pressure at the given altitude, it is 0.54 bar and temperature is 256 Kelvin. So, we calculate the propulsive efficiency, eta P equal to 2 sigma divided by 1 plus sigma. So, substituting 2 into 0.8 divided by 1 plus 0.8 equal to 0.889. which is 88.9%. The density of the air at the given altitude, rho equal to P by RT, so 0.54 into 10 power 5 divided by 287 into 256 equal to 0.735 kilogram per meter cube. Then area of the propeller A equal to pi by 4 d square, 3.14 divided by 4 into 4 square equal to 12.56 meter square. Then mass flow rate of air through the system, through the jet engine, M equal to rho A into U, 0.735 into 12.56 into 125 equal to 1153.95 kilograms per second, 1153.95 kilograms per second. Velocity of the jet, from the speed ratio, we calculate velocity of the jet, CJ equal to U by 0.8, which is 125.8 equal to 156.25. Then we calculate the thrust developed, F equal to M into CJ minus U. So, 1153.95 into 156.25 minus 125 equal to 36.06 into 10 power 3 Newton. And thrust to power equal to thrust into the flight speed. So, 36.06 into 10 power 3 into 125 equal to 4507.5 into 10 power 3 watts. So, the answer to the problem, propulsive efficiency is 88.9%, thrust equal to 36.06 kN and thrust power equal to 4507.5 kilowatts. Example number 2 from November 2003, November 2004 and November 2009 question paper. A turbojet propels an aircraft at a speed of 9000 kilometers per hour while taking 3000 kilograms of air per minute. The isentropic enthalpy drop in the nozzle is 200 kilojoules per kilogram and the nozzle efficiency is 90%. The airfield ratio is 85 and the combustion efficiency is 95%. The calorific value of the fuel is 42,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Calculate the propulsive power, thrust to power, thermal efficiency and the propulsive efficiency. We write down the given data, flight speed 900 kilometers per hour, which is 250 meters per second, mass of the air is 3000 kilograms per minute, which is 50 kilograms per second, air fuel ratio is 85, calorific value of the fuel is 42,000 kilojoules per kilogram, nozzle efficiency is 0.9, combustion efficiency is 0.95 and the enthalpy drop in the nozzle is 200 kilojoules per kilogram. We calculate the velocity of the jet at the exit of the nozzle, so CJ equal to CE equal to square root of 2 into delta H into nozzle efficiency. So, square root of 2 into 200 into 1000 into 0.9. So, we have to substitute the delta H in joules here. So, multiply by 1000. So, calculating velocity is 600 meters per second. mass of the fuel from the air fuel ratio, we calculated the mass of the fuel. Mass of the fuel equal to mass of air divided by air fuel ratio, 50 divided by 85 equal to 0.588 kilograms per second. Mass of the total mass of the air and the fuel, m equal to ma plus mf. So 50 plus 0.588 equal to 50.588 kilograms per second. The thrust developed equal to F equal to ma plus mf into cj minus ma into u. So 50.58, the mass of the gas into jet velocity minus mass of the air into flight speed. That is the equation, thrust developed. 50.588 into 600 minus 50 into 200 equal to 17,852.8 Newton. The thrust power or the propulsive power F into u, it is equal to 17,852.8 into 250 equal to 4.463 into 10 power 6 watts. So thermal efficiency of the jet engine, eta thermal equal to m into cj square minus u square divided by 2 into mf into cv into combustion efficiency. So substituting 50.588 into 600 square minus 250 square divided by 2 into 0.588 into 42,000 into 1000 into 0.95 equal to 0.32, which is 32%. Propulsive efficiency, eta p equal to 2u by cj plus u, so 2 into 250 divided by 600 plus 250 equal to 0.588, which is 58.8%. The answer to the problem, propulsive power is 17,852.8 Newton, thrust power is 4.463 megawatts, thermal efficiency is 32%, propulsive efficiency is 58.8%. Example number 3 from May 2004 question paper, calculate the thrust, specific thrust of the jet propulsion unit whose data were given below. Total head isentropic efficiency of the compressor 80%, total head isentropic efficiency of the turbine 85%, total pressure ratio including combustor pressure loss is 4:1, combustion efficiency is 98%, mechanical transmission efficiency is 99%, nozzle efficiency is 90%, maximum cycle temperature is 1000 Kelvin, airflow rate is 220 newtons per second. For air, you take Cp equal to 1005 joules per kilogram Kelvin, gamma equal to 1.4. For gas, Cp equal to 1153 joules per kilogram Kelvin and gamma equal to 1.3. Ambient pressure and temperatures are 1 bar and 15 degrees Celsius. Neglect the weight of the fuel. So, this is the temperature entropy diagram for the thermodynamic cycle of the jet propulsion engine. So 1 to 2 is in the compressor, 2 to 3 is the combustor, 3 to 4 in the turbine. So we are given compressor efficiency 0.8, turbine efficiency 0.85, pressure ratio 4, combustion efficiency 98.98, transmission efficiency 0.99, nozzle efficiency 0.9, T3 equal to 1000 Kelvin, mass of the air equal to 220 newtons per second, which is 22.426 kilograms per second. Air property 1005 joules per kilogram Kelvin, gamma equal to 1.4. Gas property Cp equal to 1153 joules per kilogram Kelvin, gamma equal to 1.3. Ambient conditions 1 bar and 15 degree Celsius. The compressor work, from the compressor work, Wa equal to isentropic work divided by the compressor efficiency. So, isentropic work in terms of temperature, T2 minus T1 equal to 1 by eta C T2S minus T1, which is 1 by eta C T1 into T2S by T1 minus 1, which is 1 by eta C T1 into pressure ratio of the compressor to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma minus 1. So, substituting T2 minus T1, temperature rise across the compressor, T2 minus T1 equal to 1 by 0.8 into 288 into 4 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 minus 1 equal to 175.2 Kelvin. Temperature at the outlet of the turbine. So, work of the compressor equal to work of the turbine into transmission efficiency. So, Cpa into T2 minus T1 equal to Cpg into T3 minus T4 into transmission efficiency. Substituting Cpa equal to 1.005, T2 minus T1 equal to 175.2, Cpg equal to 1.153, T3 equal to 1000, T4 is the unknown and transmission efficiency is 0.99. So, calculating T4, temperature at the outlet of the turbine, T4 equal to 845.8 Kelvin. Then we calculate the turbine work. Actual turbine work equal to isentropic work into turbine efficiency. So, T3 minus T4 equal to T3 minus T4S into turbine efficiency. So, T3 into 1 minus T4S by T3 into eta T. So T3 into 1 minus 1 by pressure ratio of the turbine to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma into turbine efficiency. Substituting 1000 minus T4 equal to T4S equal to 845.8 equal to T3 equal to 1000 into 1 minus 1 by PRT, pressure ratio of the turbine to the power 1.3 minus 1 divided by 1.3. So gamma for the gases is 1.3 into turbine efficiency 0.85. So from this equation, we calculate the pressure ratio of the turbine, which is P3 by P4 equal to 2.37. So pressure at the exit of the turbine, P4 equal to P3 divided by 2.37. So P3 equal to 4 divided by 2.37 equal to 1.69 bar. For nozzle, T4 by T5S equal to P4 by P5 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So which is 1.69 divided by P5 is the atmospheric pressure 1 bar. 1.3 minus 1 divided by 1.3 equal to 1.13. So temperature at the exit of the nozzle, T5S equal to T4 divided by 1.13 equal to 845.8 divided by 1.13 equal to 747.8 Kelvin. So T4 minus T5 equal to T4 minus T5S into nozzle efficiency. So from the for the nozzle. So substituting 845.8 minus T5 equal to 845.8 minus 747.8 into 0.9. So right hand side is 88.2. So T5 equal to 845.8 minus 88.2 equal to 757.6 Kelvin. The temperature, the actual temperature at the outlet of the nozzle is 757.6 Kelvin. So velocity of the gas at the outlet of the nozzle, C5 equal to square root of 2 into CPG into T4 minus T5. Square root of 2 into 1153 into 845.8 minus 757.6 equal to 451 meters per second. So thrust equal to MA into CJ. This equal to MA into C5. MA into C5 which is 22.426 into 451 equal to 10,114 Newton. So specific thrust equal to F divided by M. So 10,114 divided by 220 equal to 45.971 second to the power minus 1. So the answer to the problem, the thrust developed is 10,114 Newton and the specific thrust is 45.971 second to the power minus 1. Example number 4 from November 2008 question paper. At an ambient pressure of 660 kilopascal and 299 Kelvin, a turbojet has a flight velocity of 800 kilometers per hour. The properties of gas entering the nozzle are 300 kilopascal and 473 Kelvin. The mass flow rate of air is 220 kilograms per second. Find out the thrust developed, thrust power and propulsive efficiency. Properties of air, gamma equal to 1.4 and Cp equal to 1005 joules per kilogram Kelvin. We write down the given data. Pa equal to pressure, atmospheric pressure is 60 kilopascal, temperature is 299 Kelvin. Flight speed 800 kilometers per hour, which is 222.2 meters per second. Stagnation pressure 300 kilopascal. Stagnation temperature 473 Kelvin. Mass of the air 20 kilograms per second. Gamma equal to 1.4 and Cp equal to 1005 joules per kilogram Kelvin. We calculate the nozzle pressure ratio. Nozzle pressure is PE by PO. So exit pressure divided by the stagnation pressure 60 by 300 equal to 0.2. From the isentropic table, at this pressure ratio 0.2 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take ME equal to 1.71, TE by TO equal to 0.631. So ME is the exit Mach number of the gas jet and TE by TO is the static to stagnation temperature ratio at the exit of the nozzle. So from the data, we calculate the exit temperature TE equal to 0.631 into TO, which is 0.631 into 473 equal to 298.46. Kelvin. The exit velocity of the gas at the exit of the nozzle CE equal to CJ equal to ME into square root of gamma RTE 1.71 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 298.46 equal to 592.2 meters per second. So thrust developed F equal to MA into CJ minus U. So 20 into 592.2 minus 222.2 equal to 7400 Newton. Thrust power equal to thrust into flight speed, F into U, 7400 into 222.2 equal to 1.64 into 10 power 6 watts. The propulsive efficiency, eta p equal to 2u by CJ plus U. So 2 into 222.2 divided by 592.2 plus 222.2 equal to 0.545 equal to 54.5%. So the answer to the problem, thrust equal to 7400 newton, thrust power equal to 1.64 megawatts, and propulsive efficiency is 54.5%. Example number 5, an aircraft takes 45 kilograms per second of air from the atmosphere and flies at a speed of 950 kilometers per hour. The air-fuel ratio is 50 and the calorific value of the fuel is 42 megajoules per kilogram. The maximum thrust power, for maximum thrust power, find the jet velocity, thrust, specific thrust, thrust power, propulsive efficiency, thermal efficiency, overall efficiency, thrust specific fuel consumption. So this question is from May 2014 question paper. We write down the given data, mass of the air equal to 45 kilograms per second, flight speed equal to 950 kilometers per hour, which is 263.89 meters per second, air fuel ratio is 50, calorific value is 42,000 megajoules per kilogram. For maximum thrust to power, sigma, speed ratio sigma equal to U by CJ equal to 0.5. So jet velocity CJ equal to U by 0.5, which is 263.89 divided by 0.5 equal to 527.8 meters per second. So mass flow rate of the gas, M equal to MA plus MF, which is MA into 1 plus MF by MA. So MA equal to 45 into 1 plus 1 by air fuel ratio. Substituting air fuel ratio, M mass of the gas M equal to 45 into 1 plus 1 by 50 equal to 45.9 kilograms per second. Thrust equal to F equal to, thrust F equal to M into CJ minus MA into U. So 45.9 into 527.8. minus 45 into 263.89 equal to 12,350.97 newton. Specific thrust Fs equal to F divided by M. So 12,350.97 divided by 45.9 equal to 269.1 newton second per kilogram. The thrust power equal to P equal to thrust into the flight speed F into U. 12,350.97 into 263.89 equal to 3.26 into 10 power 6 watts. Propulsive efficiency eta p equal to 2 sigma by 1 plus sigma, which is 2 into 0.5 divided by 1 plus 0.5 equal to 0.666, which is 66.6%. Thermal efficiency eta thermal equal, thermal efficiency eta equal to m into cj square minus u square divided by 2 into mf into cv. So substituting 45.9 into 527.8 square minus 263.89 square divided by 2 into 0.9 into 42,000 into 1000. So 42 megajoules per kilogram, which is 42,000 into 1000 equal to 0.1268 equal to 12.68%. Overall efficiency equal to eta O equal to eta P plus eta T. So propulsive efficiency into thermal efficiency. So 0.666 into 0.1268 equal to 0.084, which is 8.4%. Thrust specific fuel consumption TSFC equal to MF by F. 0.9 divided by 12,350.97 equal to 7.28 × 10⁻⁵ kg/N². The answer to the problem, jet velocity is 527.8 meters per second, thrust equal to 12,350.97 newton, specific thrust equal to 269.1 newton second per kilogram, thrust power equal to 3.26 in 10 power 6 watts, propulsive efficiency is 66.6%, thermal efficiency is 12.68%, overall efficiency is 8.4%. Thrust specific fuel consumption TSFC equal to 7.28 × 10⁻²/N². Example number 6. A ramjet engine propels an aircraft at a Mach number of 1.4 at an altitude of 6000 meter. The diameter of the inlet diffuser at entry is 40 cm and the calorific value of the fuel is 43 megajoules per kilogram. The stagnation temperature at the nozzle entry is 1500 Kelvin. Properties of the combustion gases are the same as the air, which is gamma equal to 1.4 and R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin. Determine the following. Efficiency of ideal cycle, flight speed, air flow rate, diffuser pressure ratio, fuel air ratio, nozzle pressure ratio, nozzle jet Mach number, propulsive efficiency and the thrust. Assume diffuser efficiency is 0.92, combustion efficiency is 0.98, nozzle efficiency is 0.95 and stagnation pressure loss in the combustor is 0.02 times of PO2. So this question is from November 2014 question paper. So we are given M1 equal to 1.4, diameter of the diffuser is 0.4 meter, calorific value is 43 megajoules per kilogram, TO3 temperature at the entry of the nozzle 1500 Kelvin, gamma equal to 1.4, R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin, diffuser efficiency 0.92, combustion efficiency 0.98, nozzle efficiency 0.95 and delta PO pressure drop equal to 0.02 times of PO2. From the gas table, page number 20, at an altitude of 6000 meter, temperature is 249.15 Kelvin, sonic velocity A equal to 316.5 meters per second, P1 equal to 0.472 bar and density equal to 0.66 kilogram per meter cube. We calculate thermal efficiency of the ideal cycle for the gas turbine cycle, eta I equal to 1 plus 2 by gamma into 1 by M1 square to the power minus 1, so substituting 1 plus 2 by 1 plus 1.4 minus 1 into 1 by 1.4 square to the power minus 1 equal to 0.2816, which is 28.16%. Flight speed u equal to m1 into a1. So a1 is the acoustic velocity at the ambient condition, which is 1.4 into 316.5 equal to 443.1 meters per second. Airflow rate ma equal to rho 1 into pi by 4 d square into u. So rho 1 is 0.66. Area equal to 3.14 divided by 4 into diameter 0.4 square into 443.1 equal to 36.73 kilograms per second. Diffuser pressure ratio equal to, from the definition of efficiency of the diffuser, we calculate the pressure ratio as 1 plus efficiency of diffuser C1 square divided by 2 into Cp into T1 to the power gamma by gamma minus 1. So substituting the values, 1 plus 0.92 into 443.1 square divided by 2 into 1005 into 249.15 to the power 1.4 divided by 1.4 minus 1 equal to 2.94. The stagnation pressure at the exit of the diffuser, PO2 is the stagnation pressure at the exit of the diffuser equal to the pressure ratio of the diffuser into inlet pressure. So 2.94 into 0.472 equal to 1.39 bar. The stagnation temperature in the nozzle, TO1 equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M1 square into T1, which is equal to 1 plus 1.4 minus 1 divided by 2 into 1.4 square into 249.15 equal to 346.8 Kelvin. The stagnation temperature TO2 at the inlet of the nozzle is equal to the inlet of the machine, inlet of the jet engine, TO1 equal to TO2 equal to 346.8 Kelvin. For the combustor, the mass of the fuel, MA into CP into TO3 minus TO2 equal to eta combustion into combustion efficiency into mass of the fuel into calorific value. So substituting 36.73 into 1.005 into 1500 minus 346.8 equal to 0.98 into mass of the fuel into 43,000. So calculating mass of the fuel equal to 1.01 kilograms per second. The fuel air ratio, mass of the fuel divided by mass of the air. So mass of the fuel equal to 1.01, mass of the air, it is given as 36.73 equal to 0.0275. For combustor, the pressure at the outlet of the combustor, PO3 equal to PO2 minus the pressure drop. So pressure drop equal to 0.02 times of PO2. So it is 1.39 minus 0.02 into 1.39 equal to 1.362 bar. So the pressure at the outlet of the combustor. So nozzle pressure ratio, PO3 by P4. So PO3 is the stagnation pressure of the nozzle entry divided by P4 is the static pressure of the nozzle exit. So 1.362 divided by 0.472 equal to 2.88. The nozzle exit Mach number, TO4 by T4S equal to PO3 by P4 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is 2.88 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 1.35. Then T4S equal to TO4 divided by 1.35, which is 1500. TO4 is the temperature at the inlet of the nozzle, which is T4 divided by 1.35 equal to 1111.1 Kelvin. Then from the nozzle efficiency, we write the equation. The enthalpy drop, actual enthalpy drop in the nozzle equal to isentropic enthalpy drop into nozzle efficiency. So TO3 minus T4 equal to nozzle efficiency into TO3 minus T4S, substituting 1500 minus T4 equal to 0.95 into 1500 minus 1111.1. So the temperature, static temperature at the outlet of the nozzle is 1130.5 Kelvin. So the velocity, A4, the acoustic velocity at the outlet of the nozzle is equal to square root of gamma R T4, which is 1.4 into 287 into 1130.5 equal to 673.97 meters per second. So, velocity of the gas velocity at the outlet of the nozzle, square root of 2 Cp into TO3 minus T4, which is 2 into square root of 2 into 1005 into 1500 minus 1130.5, which is 861.79 meters per second. So, the Mach number at the nozzle exit, M4 equal to C4 divided by A4, which is 861.79 divided by 673.97 equal to 1.3. The Mach number of the jet equal to outlet of the nozzle is 1.3. Propulsive efficiency, sigma, we calculate sigma u by cj, 443.1 divided by A61.79 equal to 0.51. So, the propulsive efficiency equal to 2 sigma by 1 plus sigma equal to 2 into 0.51 divided by 1 plus 0.51 equal to 0.675, which is 67.5%. The thrust developed by the engine, F equal to ma plus mf into C4 minus ma into u, substituting 36.73 plus 1.01 into 861.79. Minus 36.73 into 443.1 equal to 16.25 in 10 power 3 watts. So, the answer to the problem, thermal efficiency of the ideal cycle 28.16%, flight speed 443.1 meters per second, air flow rate 36.73 kilograms per second, diffuser pressure ratio 2.94, fuel air ratio 0.0275, nozzle pressure ratio 2.88, nozzle jet Mach number 1.3, propulsive efficiency 67.5%, and the thrust equal to 16.25 megawatt. I stop here. So, these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering. You may find the gas dynamics and jet propulsion book. You can refer to the book for additional problems in the aircraft propulsion. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You refer to the subscribe the channel and use the videos for your better learning. Thanks for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in another video lecture on the gas dynamics and jet propulsion. Until then, bye-bye.